गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स। इन द पैरासिटोलॉजी वी स्टडी द लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ द टिक। लास्ट लेक्चर वी आर स्टडी द मॉर्फोलॉजी, डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ दिस सेक्सेस आर सेपरेटेड कर दिए। वी स्टडी द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम, फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम, कॉपुलेशन, ओवुलेशन, फर्टिलाइजेशन एंड ओपोजिशन। एंड एक्चुअली दिस टिक इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एक्टो एज वेल एज समटाइम पार्शियली एंडोपैरासाइट ब्लड सकिंग एनिमल। एंड एक्चुअली दिस टिक दे फाउंड इन ऑल नंबर ऑफ द डोमेस्टिकेट एनिमल इंक्लूडिंग मैन एज वेल एज द वाइल्ड एनिमल। एंड इन दैट एनिमल पर्टिकुलरली 800 डिफरेंट स्पीशीज एंड एवरी स्पीशीज चेंज द लाइफ साइकिल स्टेजेस। पर्टिकुलरली इन दैट एनिमल लाइफ साइकिल कंसिस्ट ऑफ four different stages. Which four different stages? One is the egg. Life cycle consists of the eggs. Second one is called as the larva. Third is the nymph. And the fourth is the adult stage. That is life cycle of the tick. Bacillus microbus consists of the eggs, larva, nymph, and then adults are the present. Particularly, one by one, that is the eggs. In that animal, the eggs are very small in size. Particularly, these are the heart and vexes cells are present. This female reproductive system consists of the accessory glands are present. These accessory glands on each egg surrounded by vexes gland and heart cells are formed. And this female lay the eggs about few hundred to the few thousand. That is each female different species to species, the egg laying production and the capacity is the different. And particularly few hundred to few thousand eggs are released in single batches. And actually there are the number of the pieces. There are the pieces of the ambuloma pieces. Particularly 20,000 eggs are laid by the in the case. Particularly in the Bacillus microbus 2,000 to 4,500 eggs are released. In the soft tick, the species is called the Persicus. The eggs are released 500 to 900 in the 7 batches. Means particularly 100 to 120 eggs in the per days. That is in the 7 days, there are the these releases are actually in that each batch containing 100 eggs. Eggs are very smaller. These eggs hatch particularly 2 to 7 weeks. That is the this period is depends on the temperature and humidity. And actually these eggs are hatched at the period of this start of the rainy season. That is in the month of the June to July. In that region, embryonic development depends on the temperature. If higher temperature, the development is fast. That is in the tick, eggs are incubate and hatching. The temperature is the most favorable condition. These are largest and highest temperature. These are the favorable for the growth and the incubation of the eggs, and eggs are hatched to produce the young one. This young one is called as the larva, or it is called as the seed stick. That is the eggs after they burst out the cell, and the small larvas are developed. This larva is very small, particularly very active, and they creep upon the blades of the grasses. That is the egg hatch. These eggs sometimes present into the cracks, crevices. This larva comes out. Sometimes these eggs present into the host body. The eggs hatch, new larva are produced. They live from the host body. This climb up on the glass of the blood. Sometimes eggs are present inside the grasses. These eggs hatch, this larva comes out, and they are the in the rainy season the grass are developed. They come out to the grass of the blood. That time this larva come wait from the suitable host. These cattle, dog, noodle for attachment, because these cattle, dog for the purpose of the feeding come into this nearest to the grasses region. Sometimes they rest on the grasses. The deer, rabbit rest on the grasses, dog rest on this farming region. That time these larva immediately attach, and this larva is very small, very active. Three pairs of the legs are present, or six legged larvas are present. These larvae get attached to the host body immediately, very active, suck the blood. In the some host, these larvae cannot drop out. These larvae at one time attached to the host body, the complete all number of this remaining life cycle changes. That is, this larva to name to the adult. Some species, this larva suck the continuously feed up of the blood and they drop out the change host. That is the first host. Again, they are attached to the another host in the next change. That is, one they are the drop out after the fulfilling the blood meal and they are come take place into the shelter for the suitable place. Digest the blood meal under the first molting and emerge the nymph with the four legs. Means these larva attack the host, they continue the host. Some species larva complete the blood meal process is completed, feeding is completed, leave from the host and settle into the grasses. Blood get digest and that time the ecdysis of the moltings are takes place. And actually, that is in the some teeth is called as a two host teeth change the host. Three host teeth means this host life cycle is completed more than the host. Only in the this larval condition, blood filling process is completed, leave from the host. Again, next time they attach to the new host and again new stage are developed. After this larva hatch, that is the produce the ecdysis, the third stage is called as the nymph stage. This nymph is the similar to the adult, very smaller in size. In that nymph, fourth legs are developed. That is, these are the four pairs of the legs. That is the difference between the larvae and the nymph. Nymph are four legs are developed, but these are the not sexually mature, similar to the adult. Genital pore is the absent, and these are the due to the hot weathers. Nymph goes to the rest under the grasses of the tree. That is, this nymph not a favorable for the higher temperature. Weather is hot, that time leave from the host. That is, these are the temperature is very important in the nymph stage. In the medium temperature, that time they grow, and particularly in that animal, this species, that is the every time nymph condition is view from the longest from species to species. That is the resinous sanguineous species. The nymph are view up to the 6 months, as well as the resinous 1 year viewer. This nymph after rest into 27th month, these are the developed in the adult stages without blood meal. This sanguineous live without blood meal after the development of the adult 18th month, and they convert into the adult. That time adult is the fully developed and matured, sexual maturities are developed. In the Dharma Center under Suni, 1 year without host, sexual dimorphism is completed. This host continually serves the blood. Nymph to adult are developed, and these adult sexual dimorphism, they are completed. These are the reproduction process completed, continuously suck the blood, and that time they produce the eggs. That is, these are the life cycle of this tick body, and they completely one host, two host, or the more than the two host. The next point is the particularly present in that topic, effect of the teeth on the host. Last lecture, we study the one of the parasite teeth, biologically known as the Bophilus microplus, in the paper of the parasitology. Last lecture, we study the life cycle of this Bophilus microplus. That is, in that animal, particularly study the different parts. Actually, this animal is found in the wild animal, domesticated animal. Then we study the next point is the effect of the teeth on the host body. This teeth is the very important ectoparasite, blood sucking animal. Suck the continuous the blood of these domesticated animal, cows, cattle, dog, different wild animal, reptiles, including man also. That is, these are the spreading the different diseases. That time, due to the infection, heavy infection, large number of these symptoms and that the effect of the host body. That is, this animal, this tick is the ectoparasite and it is the hazardous animal to the man and his domesticated animal. They produce the number of these infection by the biting and the sucking of the blood of these lice. That is, this tick sucks the blood of the host body. And due to the sucking the continuous blood, this animal transferred from the anemic condition. There was a lot of the weakness, and that time, sometime due to the heavy infection, this animal largely killed the death of the organism. Particularly due to its causes, injuries of the host, that is, they are the causes, large injuries of the host, and they damage the skin and they hidden the animal. Because skin get damaged, every time they puncture the skin, release the saliva. Due to this saliva, skin puncturing, they get the large number of these injuries. As well as due to this heavy infection, these are transmitted the various type of the diseases, man as well as the domesticated animal, spreading the number of the diseases. And actually, due to the tick bite, heavy irritation. They bite every time due to the heavy irritating, and the sometimes these animals get the paralyzed. Human being is also paralyzed, as well as the different domesticated animal, cat, sheep, dog, also paralyzed. Due to the bite of the certain tick, causes the inflammation. These are the one important symptoms. Oedema, and they are the irritation of the whole bodies. That time, these different domesticated animals scrubbing the body on the tree, as well as the bark of the tree or the stem of the tree. That is the large amount of the irritation which takes place. As well as due to the heavy infection of the tick, maybe damage the of this animal organ, as well as the heel, of the health of the animal. They performs sometimes due to the heavy infection of the rim of the eardrum, some tick enter into the eardrum, that is in the eardrum of this horse, cattle can damage. As well as due to the sucking the large number of this blood of the animal, particularly the cattle, and due to the heavy infection, the decreasing the milk capacity of the animal. As well as due to the heavy infection, reproductive efficiency of these cattle they get declined. That is, these are the very important part, because in the Indian people, the agriculture, these cattle get domesticated for the purpose of the milk, and due to the heavy infection, the milk capacity get declined. Consulting to the bird animal, that is the poultry birds. These poultry birds are rearing for the production of the eggs and the meat production. These are the basic needs of the man. And that time, due to the poultry get impacted by the tick, that time these poultry birds decline the egg laying capacity. And they are the meat production, as well as the meat production capacity is also declined. That is, the weight is the loss. Due to the heavy infection, these some animal, they see cattle also die. That is, as well as these are the toxic substances synthesized and spreading to the host body. That time, this disease is called as the tick of causes. Actually, there are the transmit the different type of the microorganism from one individual to one host to another host through this tick live from the host. They enter into the another host, that time the spreading the number of the disease. Particularly, the disease is called as the tularemia disease. That is, these are also transmitted this number of these microorganisms, this tularemia disease, the different microorganisms are present. They are transmitted from one host to the another host by this tick body. Second microorganism, pathogen are transmitted by through the disease. The known as the tick paralysis. Third is the disease, microorganism is the human babesiosis. They are also transmitted from one human being to another human being. As well as the another disease is the tick typhus. That is, these are the pathogen transmitted from one cattle to the another cattle, another animal, and they transfer from the fevering condition. As well as another disease called the viral encephalitis diseases. Here also pathogen are transmitted, as well as the some of the viral, the transmitted and the produce the disease, the viral fevers. As well as this viral hemorrhagic fever, these also pathogen are transmitted simultaneously. Q fever pathogen, microorganism, relapsing fever, these all pathogen transmitted through tick from one host to the another host. And actually, these are the disease they transmitted by the different types of diseases, which animal in that the first of all disease called as the particularly disease is called as the tularemia disease. This tularemia disease transmitted host, and in that tularemia disease the pathogen is called as the P. tulariasis. This pathogen tulariasis transmitted by the tick species the Dermacentor marginatus. This Dermacentor marginatus tick, this pathogen transmitted from one host to another host, that time to produce the disease, the tularemia disease. And particularly this tularemia disease spreading the number of these mammals, as well as domestic animal, man, number of these all animals are transmitted. Second one is called as the Q fever. That is, this Q fever is transmitted through the vector tick in the Dermacentor antrasuni. And here, this pathogen is the Q, C, that is the vernal T. This pathogen is transmitted, and that time this animal transmitted by the particularly one of the fever there also presented to the mammals region. As well as another disease is called as the Rocky Mountain Spotted Fever. That is the name of this disease, Rocky Mountain Spotted Fever. And the pathogen is called the Rickettsia, that is the species transmitted by the Dermacentor antrasuni. And these are found into the different cattle. That is, the cattle immunity is very declined, and that time they suffer from the pathogen. These cattle suffer from this tick fevers, and that time due to the heavy infection, death of this also takes place. Another one disease is the tick borne type of disease. This tick borne type of disease is transmitted by the tick vector in the Persicis navae species, and there the pathogen is the B. anemiasis species. And actually this species is transmitted by the particularly cattle animals, dog animal, as well as the cat also. Last one is the particularly cattle fevers. BB genia, that is the pathogen, Bovillus and Lattus species, and they are also transmitted by the cattle. As well as the another one disease, the quinine paralysis, is also found into the horse. Main thing is there, all these diseases transmitted by the different species of the tick, and this each tick transfer the particular pathogen, and due to this pathogen the animal, domestic animal, suffer from these type of the diseases. Next one is the study the different type of this diagnostic condition. It's today we are going to the topic tick, biologically known as the Bovillus microcullus, the TYBH of zoology. Last lecture we study the systematic position, life cycle of tick, geographical distribution. This animal is the cosmopolitan worldwide distribution. Life cycle is completed in the four stages: eggs, larva, nymph, adult. And this animal life cycle is completed in one burst in some species there are the two, or some species there are the more than the two hosts. That is, according to the species to species, there the number of the hosts is changed. That is, this animal is the blood sucking animal, ectoparasite. We studied to the last lecture, and that time they produce the number of the disease. There are the tularemia disease, tick typhus, Rocky Mountain fever, Rocky Spotted fever, there are the bubonic fever. That is, these are the number of the disease transmitted by the man, as well as his domesticated property by the animal. And that time the number of the animal due to the heavy infection, they get death of this animal. Particularly today they start the diagnosis in one animal, domesticated animal. Sometimes they infected by the number of the population of the tick, that time they get diagnosis. And actually this tick can be easily observed, and they are visualized or observed by the different part of the body. That is, the tick is attached to the specific part in the ear, as well as the different body part, as well as in the part of the neck, throat, through the specialized archaeologist observed periodically they identify in the eardrum. In that region the teeth are the attached, they suck the blood, they make a wound. That time periodically in every week 2 to 3 times there are observation of these domestic property, because the cows, they are the more than the 1 lakh rupees of the price of the cows, and that's why this is property of the agricultural farmers. And that's why every animal they observe, and actually due to the observing this periodically any pathogen, particularly the tick is present in the body, they get observed. Then at one time these animals suffer from this infection of the tick, that time they observed, that time they give the proper treatment. These are the very important, because properly treat the animal, that time they free from these infected parasites and they are the protected. And how to treatment? Very simple treatment. That is, in the India there are the population of the milk producing milk cows as well as the some economically important animal. That time use the drop of the kerosene. Kerosene is a chemical, they are the controlling the tick, and the tick gets totally eradicated in that infected area. They are eradicated to the apply the drop of the kerosene, this tick are the removed. As well as another is the chloroform. These are the apply the chloroform, that time this tick is totally eradicated. That is the kerosene and the chloroform. Second one is the acaricides, as well as the another number of the drugs medical available. They are the ticicides, chemical, as well as the arsenical compounds. Different type of the arsenical compounds are there. These are sprayed the whole body of the animal, those eradicated, infected, as well as this spray, or they are the DDT powder. Second one is the BSC powder. This DDT BSC apply periodically, that time this animal free from the tick. Eggs, larva, pupa, different stages is the immediately kill and the leave purpose. As well as the gamaraxin. These are the different taxin, toxic chemical from the tick, and that time they are periodically apply this different type of the chemicals, and that time they cure the diseases. Now what is the different type of the preventive measures? This animal, human property, free from the tick, there are different types of preventive measures, because preventive measure then is better than the cure. That time, first we need the different precaution is there, that time this animal, human property get protected from the tick. Which one? One is the tick-proof animal house. This is the cow's house, as well as different domesticated animal house is the tick-free. They are not a infection by the tick. This type of the construction is necessary. As well as they treat infected animal with the arachnicide periodically. Some animal is the infected. That time these animal are the isolated from the whole animal. They apply the acaricide, different type of chemical component, and they are the free from the tick. Because these animal cannot be isolated automatically, all animal get infected. That time these are the isolation is very important, and they give the proper treatment. Sometimes in that animal options spray acaricidal compound, ticicidal compound periodically, that time there is some eggs or some larvae, they are not totally eradicated. Periodically they are spraying, seal the cracks and the crevices in the animal house, particularly in the poultry birds. Because the poultry birds is changing every month, there are the different small as well as the large, and in the cracks and the crevices of the poultry birds, these animals in the nocturnal and the night time they suck the blood of these poultry birds, and that time these poultry birds get affected to the egg production as well as the meat production. That time these poultry birds is very important from the sealing the cracks and the crevices, as well as different ticky sites, ear tag, ear bands, neck band. These are the available in the market, they are useful. As well as the human being is protected from the use the protected tick cloth at the time of the handling the animal. There are the milk as well as the cleaning of the animal, that a human being use the protected cloth from the tick infection. As well as in that locality animal also spray the different type of the repellent. Due to the smelling of the repellent, this tick leave from the as well as the human being give the one precaution, avoiding the visiting as well as the walking the infected area. Those area large amount of the critique each patient. We rearrange our mind automatically. This human being also, some animal also, they are the protector from this infection. As well as in this postal rotation method, that is to change the animal in that tick animal house due to the postal rotation method, where the population of the infection is avoided. Different type of the plant repellent is available in the market. They are useful. That time, these larvae, they are the immovable and they are the life cycle is arrested. Some, next one is the parasitic adaptation of the tick. There are the, these animals, the ectoparasites, shampiorous animal, soft bodied tick, nocturnal animal. Without food, they survive more than 1 to 1 year. Mouth part is the piercing and second type. Saliva is the anticoagulant substance. Digestion is the diabetic blood. They store the large amount of the blood. Elastic impingement. And tick attached to their host, they cannot be removed. That is, these are the parasitic adaptation. That is, ectoparasite easily attached to the outer surface of the body. Blood sucking large amount continuously. That's why called as the sanguivorous. Body of disease soft tip. Nocturnal and the night time they suck the large amount of the blood. Without blood, they survive more than a year. That is, these are the all parasitic adaptation. And due to this overall, this is controlling by the different type of the methods. That time the tick protect animal and actually animal free from the protection. That is, these are the very important in the India of the agricultural sectors. Okay, next lecture we study the another animal. Okay, thank you.